In the scorching summer of 1943, amidst the vast plains of Western Russia, the fate of World War II hung in the balance. The Battle of Kursk, one of the largest tank battles in history, unfolded as a decisive clash between the German Wehrmacht and the Soviet Red Army. This monumental engagement marked a turning point in the Eastern Front, altering the course of the war and contributing to the eventual downfall of Nazi Germany. By mid-1943, the tide of the war on the Eastern Front had shifted in favor of the Soviet Union. The Germans had suffered defeats at Stalingrad and in the Caucasus, weakening their overall strategic position. However, they still possessed a formidable military machine and were determined to regain the initiative. As the Nazis marched eastward, capturing vast territories, they aimed to deliver a crushing blow to the Soviet Union. Their target was Kursk, a salient bulging into German-occupied territory. Recognizing the impending attack, the Soviets began preparing a formidable defense. The stage was set for a confrontation that would test the limits of military might and strategy. Adolf Hitler planned an offensive code named Operation Citadel, with the aim of eliminating the Kursk salient, a bulge in the front lines that exposed the Soviets to potential encirclement. The operation was intended to be a Blitzkrieg-style attack, reminiscent of earlier German successes, but the Soviets were well aware of the plan through intelligence sources and their own reconnaissance efforts. The Soviets, under the leadership of General Georgi Zhukov, were determined to blunt the German offensive. They used the intelligence they had gathered to construct an elaborate defensive network. This network included extensive minefields, anti-tank obstacles, and well-fortified defensive positions. The Soviets had also mass-produced new tanks, such as the T-34 and KV-1, which were well-suited to combating German armor.
The German forces, led by Field Marshal Erich von Manstein and General Walter Model, amassed a substantial armored force for the operation. They planned to attack the Kursk salient from two directions, north and south, with the goal of encircling and annihilating the Soviet forces. The battlefield itself covered an area of nearly 6,000 square miles, a vast expanse of rolling hills, villages, and open fields. The Soviets planned to absorb the initial German assault through heavily fortified defense lines, inflicting maximum damage before launching a counteroffensive. The Battle of Kursk began on July 5, 1943, with the Germans launching their attacks. The northern offensive, known as the Battle of Rzhev, faced strong Soviet resistance and made limited progress. The southern offensive, however, saw initial gains as German forces advanced through Soviet defensive lines. In the northern sector, German forces encountered stubborn Soviet resistance. The Soviets, forewarned of the German plans, had constructed a formidable defensive network of minefields and fortifications. The Germans struggled to make substantial progress against the well-prepared Soviet lines. Meanwhile, in the southern sector, the German offensive saw some initial success. Their armored units breached the Soviet defensive positions, causing concern for the Soviets. However, the Soviets swiftly adapted their tactics, employing a combination of skillful maneuvering and strategic withdrawals. This allowed them to funnel the German forces into kill zones, where they were subjected to devastating counterattacks. By mid-July, the German offensive had lost much of its initial momentum. The Soviets, under General Georgi Zhukov's leadership, exploited their defensive advantages and launched counteroffensives. These efforts not only blunted the German advances, but also set the stage for a shift in the battle's favor. The Soviets would go on to capitalize on their successes, encircling German positions and setting the stage for the later stages of the battle. One of the most iconic engagements of the Battle of Kursk occurred at the Battle of Prokhorovka, a major tank engagement within the southern offensive. On July 12, 1943, Soviet and German tank forces clashed in a massive armored battle. The Soviets, with their well-designed tanks and effective tactics, managed to repel the German armored units and inflicted heavy losses. This marked a significant turning point in the battle as it shattered the myth of German invincibility in tank warfare. The battle saw intense tank battles, with both sides employing a variety of tanks, including the Soviet T-34 and the German Panther and Tiger tanks. The Soviets used the T-34's mobility and reliability to their advantage, while the Germans relied on the superior armor and firepower of their heavy tanks. As the battle progressed, it became evident that the German offensive was losing steam. Soviet counteroffensives, launched in late July and early August, pushed the Germans back further. The Soviets exploited the weaknesses created by the failed German attacks and started encircling German positions. The Soviet counteroffensive, codenamed Operation Kutuzov, began on July 12th. The Soviets attacked the German flanks and managed to encircle several German divisions. The German forces were pushed back, and the Soviet advance continued. By August 23, 1943, the battle officially concluded. The Soviets had successfully defended their territory, repelled the German offensive, and decisively shifted the momentum of the war on the Eastern Front. The Battle of Kursk marked a clear turning point as the last major German offensive effort in the East. The Battle of Kursk had far-reaching implications for the remainder of World War II. The German defeat shattered their aura of invincibility and effectively halted their offensive capabilities on the Eastern Front. This marked the beginning of a series of Soviet offensives that would ultimately lead to the capture of Berlin in 1945. The battle also highlighted the effectiveness of combined arms tactics, with infantry, artillery, and tanks working in coordination to achieve victory. It demonstrated the importance of strong defensive preparations, intelligence gathering, and adaptability in the face of changing circumstances. In conclusion, the Battle of Kursk was a pivotal engagement that significantly altered the course of World War II. The Soviet victory not only halted German ambitions on the Eastern Front, but also paved the way for the Soviets to take the initiative and push the Germans back across Europe. The battle remains a testament to the resilience and determination of the Soviet people, as well as a lesson in the strategic and tactical intricacies of large-scale warfare. Battle resulted in massive casualties on both sides. Estimates vary, but it's believed that the Soviets suffered around 800,000 casualties, dead, wounded, missing, while the Germans suffered around 200,000 to 250,000 casualties. Following the battle, the Soviets continued their offensive operations and gradually pushed the Germans back westward. The victory at Kursk paved the way for the Soviets to launch successful offensives that eventually led to the liberation of Eastern Europe and the fall of Berlin in 1945. Thanks for watching. Remember to like, share, and subscribe for our new content. Stay tuned for next video.